Hello guys, I welcome you to this video lecture. In the last lecture we discussed about valence band and conduction band, and in today's lecture we are going to discuss about semiconductor. So in today's lecture we are going to discuss about few points. The first point that we are going to discuss is classification of solid. So we are going to classify solid as metal, insulators and semiconductor, and how they are classified on the basis of band theory. The second thing that we are going to do is we are going to see what are the types of semiconductor. Then we are going to discuss about doping and n-type and p-type semiconductors. In this particular topic we are also going to discuss about impurity level which are two types of impurities, so donor and acceptor level. And in the last part we are going to look at what will happen to a semiconductor at different temperature. Okay, so these are the points that we are going to discuss in today's lecture. So let's begin our discussion. In the last lecture we said that in a solid there are two types of bands. This is valence band, and on top of the valence band there is a conduction band. While discussing about valence band, we said that this particular band is created from the valence shells, or this particular band will contain electrons. This is the topmost band in which electron is occupied, and in conduction band there is no electrons at all. So whatever discussion I am doing over here, it is valid at 0 degree Kelvin. Okay, at 0 degree Kelvin valence band contains electrons, and conduction band is completely empty. This is valid for 0 degree Kelvin. If the temperature is higher, a situation will be a little bit different. So you see there is a gap between this valence band and conduction band. This gap is known as band gap. So there is a gap, and this is known as band gap, and it is denoted by E suffix G. So this is a band gap. Now on the basis of this particular thing we are going to classify materials as metals, semiconductors and insulators. In order to understand how these materials are classified as metal, semiconductor and insulators, we need to know a few things. Now we said that if I have a piece of material and I connect it to some power supply or battery, the electron will move from negative terminal to positive terminal, and there will be a flow of current from positive terminal to negative terminal. So there will be a flow of current, right? That's what we said. But in order to make this electron move, I require free electrons. The electrons, if I look at a microscopic scale, this is the atom, this is the nucleus, and surrounding it is the orbitals, and in this particular orbital there will be an electron. So let me show it with a different color. So there is an electron over here, and if it is bound to this particular atom, and if I connect some potential over here, because of this potential, since the electron is bound to this particular atom, this electron cannot move. However, if I have a free electron over here, something like this, then only this electron can move. So this electron is free because it is not bound to any atom, right? So the important thing is that for conduction of electron, for conduction property, I require unbound electron. I am not using free electron over here because free electron concept is only for metal. Okay, so I require unbound electron. How can I show that over here? In terms of this Venn diagram, how can I show this? So in order to make conduction, I need a vacant state. As we have seen in the last lecture, this band is made up of many energy levels, right? And each energy level is contains two states per energy level. In order to have electrical conduction, I need free state. For example, if electron is filled over here, over here, over here, over here, over here, over here. So all these states, if all these states are filled, and if I connect it to some, let's say this material is connected to power supply, then this electron cannot move, because in order to move this electron, it needs a free space. So let me give you an analogy so that you can understand it in a better fashion. Suppose you have a room. All the students are filled up in this particular room. So this room is completely filled with students, and there is a door over here, and somebody came from this particular room with a gun and said, "Get back, get back, get back." Okay, what's going to happen? All of you will try to go back in this particular direction, right? But since this room is completely filled, there is no empty space at all, can somebody move from this particular point backward? Nobody can move, right? And suppose something is similar is happening over here, but in this particular room there are only 10 students and there are lots of free space available, and the same thing happens. Somebody came with a gun and ask you to go back, ask this particular people to go back. What's going to happen? This can easily move, right? This also can easily move. 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 So all these particular people can move around. Whereas in this particular case, since it is completely filled, they cannot move. So in this particular example, this room is your band, right? And these peoples are electron, and the gunman is applied potential. So if the band is completely filled, then these people cannot move. However, what is going to happen if there is a small opening over here and there is adjacent room in upside? So what may happen is that some of the people can move from here to here. Or if you don't like this particular diagram, let me redraw it. So this is a room, and there is another room adjacent to it, but at a little bit higher height. So when this particular person says, "Go back, go back, go back," this is completely filled. There is no room at all, and there is a gunman over here. And when this particular man says that, "Go back, go back, go back," some of the people can open this particular door and they can enter over here and then they can easily move around. Similarly, another people can enter and they can move easily around. Okay, so this filled room is, or this particular filled room is valence band, and this particular empty room is conduction band. Now if these people can move from filled room to empty room, they can move around. Similarly, if electron goes from valence band into conduction band, they can move around. Or if there is some space in a band, so if there is a space in valence band, the valence band is not completely filled, then also the electron can move around. You're getting my point. In order to make an electron move, you need empty state, either in the same band or in the another band. So let's come back to this particular diagram now. Now, as I said, this conduction band contains electron. For the time being, let's say that this conduction band is completely filled. This will be the case in most of the time. The valence band will be completely filled. When it is will be completely filled and where it will be empty, that we are going to discuss in a minute. But for the time being, let's suppose that this valence band is completely filled. Now what is going to happen? In order to, when I apply the electric field, since this is completely filled, there is no empty state and this electron cannot move. In order to make this electron move, what I need? I need the electron from this particular band need to go to the empty state, and empty state is available in conduction band. So I need to promote an electron from valence band into conduction band. And when I can promote an electron from valence band into conduction band, then and then only the electron can conduct. But there is a gap between this particular valence band and conduction band. So in order to promote an electron from valence band into conduction band, I need to provide some kind of energy. Because this is at lower energy, this is at higher energy. So in order to move electron from lower energy to higher energy, I need to provide an energy equal to the difference in the energies of these two electrons, or these two bands, that is equal to the band gap of the material. And this can be provided by some means. You can excite an electron. This particular process of transferring electron from valence band into conduction band is known as excitation, and it can be achieved by using light, very simply, or some other means of energy. The electrical energy is not sufficient. यहाँ पे जो बैटरी से हम एनर्जी दे रहे हैं वो सफिशियंट नहीं है. दिस एनर्जी कैन नॉट प्रोमोट दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम वैलेंस बैंड इनटू कंडक्शन बैंड, राइट? सो वी डिस्कस टू थिंग्स. इन ऑर्डर टू हैव अ कंडक्शन, वी नीड एम्प्टी स्टेट. किसके लिए? फॉर electrical conduction. And the power, the battery जो हम use करते हैं, that is usually 10 volt to let's say 30 volt or 2 volt to 30 volt, is not sufficient to move electron from valence band to conduction band. और ये क्यों करना है हमें, valence band to conduction band में क्यों भेजना है electron? Because valence band is completely filled. And electrical conduction के लिए हमें क्या चाहिए? Empty state चाहिए, जो available है conduction band में. So in order to achieve this empty state, we need to move electron from valence band into conduction band, and the battery is not sufficient for that. So now, based on this particular thing, let's discuss what is metal, insulators and semiconductors. What is the property of metal? It's a good conductor of electricity. semiconductor. So let me say intermediate. Intermediate Q, because it is bad conductor at low temperature. And good conductor at high temperature. And insulator is bad conductor of electricity. So metals is a good conductor of electricity at low as well as high temperature. Semiconductor is a good conductor at low bad conductor at low temperature and good conductor at high temperature. And insulators are bad conductor at low as well as high temperature. So metal can easily conduct electricity. Insulator cannot conduct electricity. Semiconductor at low temperatures cannot conduct electricity, but at high temperature or room temperature they can conduct electricity. Okay, these are metal, semiconductor and insulator. Now how we can explain this particular phenomena of good conductor electrical conductivity on the basis of electrical conductivity using Venn diagram? Let's see that. In case of metals, there are, as I told you, there are two types of metals. One in which valence band is completely filled, and the second type is where valence band is partially filled. In most of the cases, you will encounter this type of metals. This is very rare case. So this is very rare case, and that's the reason that nobody discusses this in a textbook thing, partially filled valence band. All talk about valence band to be completely filled. So आप कोई भी किताब अगर देखोगे, टेक्सटबुक देखोगे, तो उसमें दिया होगा कि वैलेंस बैंड इज कम्प्लीटली फिल्ड, विच इज नॉट एंटायरली ट्रू. देर आर सम केसेस इन विच द वैलेंस बैंड इज नॉट कम्प्लीटली फिल्ड. इन केस ऑफ इंसुलेटर्स एंड सेमी कंडक्टर्स, सो लेट मी राइट इंसुलेटर एंड सेमी कंडक्टर, वैलेंस बैंड इज completely filled and this is at 0 degree Kelvin. Okay, so insulator ke liye this is true, valence band is completely filled, but for metals there are some metals which has partially filled valence band. So we are going to look at the both the cases. Let's talk about this second case first, because this is very rare, and even if you don't explain it in your examination, that's fine, because nobody will bother about it. Okay, so in case, suppose I have this valence band and this is my conduction band, and there is a gap between this, and let me call this as band gap. This is conduction band top, this is valence band bottom, my valence band. Okay, and the picture is something like this. So this is my atom, and this is electron bound. So जो valence band के electron जो रहेंगे वो always bound electron रहेंगे. So as I told you that since there are many atoms, these electrons are shared between these atoms, so वो free नहीं रहेंगे. This electron what can do? This electron can do, it can go from this atom to this atom, but वो bound ही रहेगा. So यहाँ पे क्या होगा, यहाँ तक पूरी की पूरी state filled up रहेंगे, बाकी के empty रहेंगे. And when you apply a potential, this electron can go to upper states, जो state a neighboring atom का रहेगा उस state में जाएगा, right? And it can conduct electricity. So since there is an empty space available over here, it can conduct electricity easily. That's very trivial. Please note, I have shown some gap between valence band and conduction band, and this is for metals. But which metals? In which the valence band is partially filled. So अभी यहाँ पे देखो zero temperature है या बहुत ज्यादा temperature, it doesn't matter, the electron can conduct electricity easily. Okay, now let's look at when the valence band is completely filled. So recall our room example. So ये मेरा valence band है और ये पूरा का पूरा भरा हुआ है. So there are no empty states available here. So मुझे क्या चाहिए? मुझे चाहिए एम्प्टी स्टेट फॉर दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन टू कंडक्ट. और मेटल की प्रॉपर्टीज क्या है? इवन एट जीरो डिग्री केल्विन एज वेल इट कंडक्ट्स. अगर आप वहां पे टेम्परेचर उसको पोटेंशियल दोगे, वोल्टेज दोगे, तो वो कंडक्ट करेगा. मेटल की प्रॉपर्टी है. सो ये कैसे करता है? इट इज पॉसिबल इफ एंड ओनली इफ जो एम्प्टी स्टेट्स है दे ओवरलैप विद द फिल स्टेट्स. So, ये फिल स्टेट जो था वो वैलेंस बैंड था एंड दिस इज कंडक्शन बैंड. सो यहाँ पे कुछ बैंड गैप रहेगा क्या? नो, द बैंड गैप इज जीरो. देयर इज नो गैप बिटवीन वैलेंस बैंड एंड कंडक्शन बैंड. सो इन केस ऑफ मेटल्स द वैलेंस बैंड एंड कंडक्शन बैंड they overlap so let me explain it using our example, earlier example. So this is the room in which all peoples are filled. In this particular room pure ka pura room filled hai, yahan pe jagah hi nahi hai. पैर एक दूसरे के ऊपर, एक पैरों पे पैर रख के लोग खड़े हैं यहाँ पे. इट इज कम्प्लीटली बिल्कुल जगह नहीं है. और उसके बाजू में एट द सेम हाइट व्हाट आई हैव अ कम्प्लीटली एम्प्टी रूम. सो दिस इज माय वैलेंस बैंड, दिस इज माय कंडक्शन बैंड और यहाँ पे दरवाजा है और यहाँ पे भी एक दरवाजा है और यहाँ पे एक गनमैन आ गया. And he said, अगर कोई पीछे नहीं जाएगा तो मैं गोली मारूंगा. सो दिस इज माई पोटेंशियल वोल्टेज, दिस इज वैलेंस बैंड, दिस इज कंडक्शन बैंड और ये फिलअप जो हुआ है यहाँ पे, दीज आर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो क्या होगा? यहाँ पे दरवाजा होने की वजह से दरवाजा खोल के दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन कैन एंटर ओवर हियर. एंड जैसे ही ये आदमी इस रूम में आएंगे, दे कैन रन अवे, राइट? सो दिस इज वॉट हैपन्स वेन आई हैव valence band, this is my valence band and conduction band. Let me use different color for conduction band. I hope this color is visible. I'm also showing a little bit different shape so that it can be visible. This is conduction band and this valence band jo tha mera, और पूरा का पूरा फिलअप है. सो दिस वैलेंस बैंड इज कंप्लीटली फिल्ड एंड कंडक्शन बैंड जो है वो मेरा एम्प्टी है. सो इलेक्ट्रॉन यहां पे देखो, उसको एनर्जी की जरूरत ही नहीं है बिल्कुल. ये यहां से डायरेक्टली यहां पे जा सकता है. एनर्जी इज इंक्रीजिंग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन. This is energy axis. Y axis is my energy axis, right? So this electron can easily go from valence band to conduction band without any energy. And यही reason है कि even at zero degree Kelvin, जहाँ पे thermal energy भी नहीं रहती है, उस वक्त भी electron can go from valence band into conduction band. This is the case of metal. Semiconductor का क्या scene है? Semiconductor में लो टेम्परेचर पे बैड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी है और रूम टेम्परेचर पे गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी है. सो सेमीकंडक्टर में क्या होता है, दिस इज कंडक्टर और मैटर. इन केस ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर्स द सेम थिंग इज ओवर हियर. सो अभी होगा क्या कि यहां पे जो रूम है ये रूम पूरा का पूरा भर जाता है, इट इज कंप्लीटली फिल्ड विद पीपल, और उसके ऊपर एक रूम है, एक एम्प्टी स्पेस है थोड़ा सा यहाँ पे जहां पे कोई रह नहीं सकता है, और उसके ऊपर एक रूम है राइट. सो यहाँ पे जो है वो गैप है, दो रूम के बीच का गैप है, वहां पे कोई खड़ा नहीं रह सकता क्योंकि वहां पे फ्लोर नहीं है. ओके सो और यहाँ पे एक रूम है, सो दिस इज माई वैलेंस बैंड, दिस इज माई कंडक्शन बैंड राइट. अभी यहाँ पे जब आदमी आएगा तो क्या होगा, जैसे ही वो दरवाजे पे गनमैन आएगा और बोलेगा पीछे जाओ, तो क्या होगा कि कुछ लोग जो है वो जंप करके, ये जो हाइट है, ये जो गैप है नीचे वाले रूम और ऊपर वाले रूम में, ये जो गैप है वो बहुत कम है, स्मॉल गैप. क्या करेंगे, जैसे ही ये बोलेगा यहाँ पे जगह ही नहीं है, तो कुछ लोग जंप करके यहां से यहाँ पे चले जाएंगे और यहां से वो भाग जाएंगे. You're getting my point, right? The same thing is happening in metal, in semiconductor. This is my valence band, which is completely filled, and over here, I have conduction band. And if you can look carefully, there is a gap between this valence band and conduction band. So there is a small gap between valence band and conduction band. Now at 0 degree Kelvin, what's going to happen? These electrons in valence band will not have sufficient energy. And hence, this electron cannot go from this valence band into conduction band. Right? Now, this band gap is of the order of few electron volt. So, in order to make this electron move from this point, this electron needs few electron volts of energy. Right? Now, when I start heating it up, so at low temperature, since there is no electricity, there is no energy, these electrons cannot go from valence band into conduction band. So at 0 degree Kelvin, there will be no conduction. Right? So यहाँ पे कैसे explain कर सकते हैं आप कि यहाँ पे जो लोग हैं वो ज्यादा हाइट पे जंप ही नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि उनके पेड़ को उन्होंने कुछ खाना नहीं खाया फॉर एग्जांपल राइट, तो वो ज्यादा ऊपर जंप नहीं कर सकते. सो दिस इज द केस एट 0 degree Kelvin. एंड एज यू स्टार्ट इंक्रीजिंग द टेम्परेचर, व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, एज यू स्टार्ट इंक्रीजिंग द टेम्परेचर, द थर्मल एनर्जी So what's going to happen if the thermal energy increases? As the thermal energy increases, these electrons get sufficient energy. These electrons can gain sufficient energy to go from this valence band into conduction band. That's very good. But can somebody tell me what is the thermal energy at room temperature? So room temperature I am considering to be 25 degrees Celsius. What is the thermal energy? The thermal energy corresponding to 25 degrees Celsius is around 25 milli electron volt. And there has to be some mistake because this gap is 1 to 5
electron volt, right? And the thermal energy at room temperature is 25 milli electron volt. So it's very, very, very small. एक इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट से भी कम है. 25 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट का मिली इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट का मतलब होता है 0.025 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. कैन दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन मेक ट्रांजिशन फ्रॉम दिस वैलेंस बैंड इनटू कंडक्शन बैंड एट रूम टेम्परेचर? द आंसर इज यस. हाउ? The reason is that when you say thermal energy, this thermal energy 25 milli electron volt is average energy. What do I mean by average energy? It means that if there are, let's say, 10 electrons, one electron can have 10 electron volt, another electron can have 15 electron volt, another electron can have 0 electron volt, another electron can have different amount of energy, but if I take the average of all these energies, it will be equal to 25 milli electron volt, right? So jin electrons ka energy is band gap honga, right? They can make a transition from here and go into conduction band. And once they go into conduction band, potential ki wajah se, they can conduct electricity, right? So jitna kam temperature rahega, utne kam electron ke paas a sufficient energy rahega, kyunki average energy bhi kam rahega, to jyada energy wale electron bhi kam rahenge. Aur jaise jaise main temperature badhate jaunga, waise waise jyada electron ke paas energy aata jayega, and they can go from valence band into conduction band. Is it clear to you? So, इस केस में क्या हो रहा है कि यहाँ पे तो गैप है, मगर जिन जिन लोगों ने यहाँ पे खाना खा लिया था, जिन जिन के पास सफिशियंट एनर्जी था, वो यहाँ से यहाँ पे जंप करके जा सकते हैं एंड वो रन आउट कर सकते हैं. और जैसे ये भाग जाएंगे, यहाँ पे स्पेस होगा, तो ये लोग भी पीछे पीछे आना शुरू कर देंगे. ओके, सो यहाँ पे जो स्पेस क्रिएट हो रहा है बिकॉज ऑफ जंपिंग ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन ओवर हियर, इट इज नोन एज hole. We are going to discuss about this hole. But right now, let's focus on this particular case. So, since at 0 degree Kelvin, these electrons don't have sufficient energy, they cannot conduct. But as you go on increasing the temperature, because of thermal energy, few electrons can go from valence band into conduction band and they can conduct electricity. And this is the reason why semiconductor is bad conductor. At low temperature and is a good conductor at high temperature. Is it clear or you have some doubt? Now, what happens in case of insulator? In case of insulators, as we discussed, insulators are bad conductor at 0 degree or high temperature, it doesn't matter. So, our hypothetical problem, example, यहाँ पे क्या है, ये room पूरा filled up है, जगह ही नहीं है, और जो दूसरा रूम है एम्प्टी वाला वो बहुत ज्यादा ऊपर है. सो कितना भी कोशिश करे ये लोग यहाँ पे जंप करने की, दे कैन नॉट जंप फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर. ओके, सो इन टर्म्स ऑफ बैंड डायग्राम, दिस इज कंडक्शन बैंड एंड दिस इज वैलेंस बैंड एंड देर इज अ ह्यूज गैप बिटवीन valence band and conduction band. So this is large band gap. Large मतलब कितना? Generally more than 5 electron volt. 5 electron volt से ज्यादा का gap रहेगा.
तो थर्मल एनर्जी की वजह से क्या होगा, फिर गैप ज्यादा होने की वजह से दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन इवन इफ दे गॉट सम एनर्जी वो यहाँ से यहाँ पे जा नहीं सकते। देर मे बी फ्यू इलेक्ट्रॉन, एक या दो इलेक्ट्रॉन रहेगा जो यहाँ से यहाँ पे जाएगा, बट इन द लास्ट लेक्चर हमने देखा था एक इलेक्ट्रॉन की वजह से करंट कितना कंडक्ट होता है, 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁰ A। ये तो आप डिटेक्ट भी नहीं कर सकते, इतना स्मॉल करंट है, राइट। सो दो इलेक्ट्रॉन जाएंगे तो 2 times दिस, 3 इलेक्ट्रॉन जाएंगे तो 3 times दिस। सो यहाँ पे बहुत ज्यादा इलेक्ट्रॉन वैलेंस बैंड से कंडक्शन बैंड में नहीं जाएंगे, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट 0 degree Kelvin पे क्या होने वाला है, 0 degree Kelvin पे तो इस इलेक्ट्रॉन के पास थर्मल एनर्जी नहीं रहेगा, सो दे कैन नॉट मूव एट ऑल। सो एट 0 degree Kelvin दिस इज अ बैड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। इवन एट रूम टेम्परेचर द थर्मल एनर्जी इज 25 mIV, एंड देर विल बी वेरी फ्यू इलेक्ट्रॉन विच कैन हैव एनर्जी ग्रेटर देन 5 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट, दो तीन ही रहेंगे। सो ओनली 2-3 इलेक्ट्रॉन कैन मूव ओवर हियर एंड ओनली दे कैन कंडक्ट, और करंट जो होगा इट विल बी ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ 10⁻¹⁹ A। सो डिटेक्ट भी नहीं होगा। अगर बहुत ज्यादा टेम्परेचर है तो भी क्या होगा, 3-4 की जगह 100, 200, 300 इलेक्ट्रॉन का सिर्फ एनर्जी क्या होगा, 5 इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट से ज्यादा होगा, एंड अगेन उनकी वजह से जो कुछ करंट होगा वो इसी ऑर्डर में रहेगा, और द करंट विल बी ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ 10⁻¹⁹ A अगर 200-300 इलेक्ट्रॉन है तो। तो ये भी तो मैं डिटेक्ट नहीं कर सकता। सो दिस इज द रीजन व्हाई इंसुलेटर्स आर बैड कंडक्टर, राइट। सो लेट्स समराइज इट ओवर हियर। सो इफ आई हैव मेटल्स और कंडक्टर, सेमीकंडक्टर एंड इंसुलेटर्स, देन इन केस ऑफ मेटल्स द वैलेंस बैंड and conduction band overlap, so the band gap is zero. This is valence band, this is conduction band, और यहाँ पे जो है overlap है, right? In case of semiconductor, this is valence band, उसके ऊपर conduction band रहेगा में जो रहेगा गैप रहेगा, बैंड गैप रहेगा इजी, बट दिस इज ऑफ द ऑर्डर ऑफ फ्यू इलेक्ट्रॉन होल्ट। और इन केस ऑफ मेटल्स दिस विल बी माय वैलेंस बैंड, और कंडक्शन बैंड यहां पे कहीं पे रहेगा, और यहां पे जो रहेगा there will be a gap, band gap, and it will be greater than 5 electron volt. So यहाँ पे Eg few electron volt, 2-3 electron volt, और यहाँ पे Eg greater than 5 electron volt. So I guess you understood how metal conduct electricity even at 0 degree Kelvin, why semiconductors are bad conductor of electricity at low temperature and good conductor of electricity at high temperature, and why insulators are bad conductor even at high temperature. Now let's discuss, our concern is about this semiconductor, because those electronic component banaye jate hain wo semiconductor se banaye jate hain. So let's discuss about this semiconductor in more detail.